My name is Fiona Tanner. I'll be showing you how to do a chimney sweep look today using the following products and explaining each product throughout. I've started by just basing the skin with a little bit of oil or something like a little bit of slip product like a moisturiser, just so the product sits a lot better. And I'm going to be using a number of different brushes and sponges to achieve the effect. So, starting with a little bit of the Ben Nye Black Professional Clown Series, I'm going to be using a little bit of the stippling sponge. So just obviously wetting the product with a little bit of spritz. So to achieve a chimney sweep look, the most important thing to do is to use a number of different brush marks to achieve the desired effect. So I'm going to start by using a stipple sponge. I'm just testing the products in the back of my hand to make sure it's got the right consistency. So I'm just going to sort of drag the product gently across the face, and then I'm going to turn around the sponge and use the dry surface just to sort of disperse the product gently and evenly across the face. And obviously just working a little bit into the hairline as well. So obviously with this kind of makeup, you actually want to be quite uneven. With obviously the straight makeup, you're looking to get the same sort of consistency and a natural finish throughout, whereas this kind of makeup you just want to make sure it's very uneven and not too pretty. You can actually work with your fingers as well into the product to get, this will create a number of smudge marks. Don't forget to also bring it down onto the neck. I'm just going to introduce another brush. So if you just use it quite lightly in circular motions, you can just drag the product right around the neck, around the ear. And if it's for TV as well, I think it's quite important to make sure it's quite durable. So this will actually buff it into the skin so it will last longer in front of the studio lights. So I'm using two techniques. So I'm using the stipple sponge just to get little drags and scratch marks, and then I'm buffing in with my circular brush. So the stipple sponge, just using it on all different types of direction, so it creates an uneven finish. Don't forget to ask the costume designer where the clothes are actually going to end, because obviously he's going to have it on his arms and also right around the collar as well. It's quite important to build up the basic design, and then you can work back into it on top. It'd be quite nice in this instance just to actually concentrate on one side of the face, because obviously you don't want the whole face covered in soot. When you get a bit more confidence with your strokes, you can just stipple the sponge in a little bit more, just pressing ever so slightly harder. Just going to drag a slight amount of products all over the face with my circular brush. So I don't really think he's going to have any real patch of skin that's going to be uncovered by soot. So again, the base of our design coming up quite nicely now. Just remember to work it into that hairline. Quite nice to make sure some of his hair is quite dishevelled as well. And maybe the brows. I think at this point you can start being a little bit more playful and bold in your stroke. So I'm just going to start really working into the face now with my large brush and being quite fluid with my movements as well. You really want to coat the end of the ears with the black soot. I'm just working it into the sideburns a little bit as well. So continuing just putting a thin layer of black soot all around the face with my circular brush, working into the hairline. And you don't want to drag the brush or press the brush too hard, you just want a very thin layer. Obviously, when you press your brush hard, you're going to get lots of product coming off and you're going to get quite an effect that builds up quite quickly. But if you want something quite soft, it's really quite important to use your brush in a feather-like motion around the face. Don't forget the eyes, of course, because they will be covered with a thin layer of soot as well. I'm actually going to get Sam here to close his eyes and really squint and squeeze with the eyes a moment. Yep, cool. A little bit more. So then just apply a thin layer of product on top. So just imagine that there's a great big cloud of soot that's just come down the chimney. If you just squeeze your eyes again. So obviously he would have closed his eyes to actually avoid that. Just look straight ahead. And that way you're just going to get some really nice detailing around the eyes. Just soften it a little bit with your brush. Now obviously for TV it's quite important to make sure that there's quite a few different details and quite a few different ranges of colour in there. This, you know, black is probably fine for the stage because people are going to see it from a long way away. But for TV, you've also got to bear in mind the character's background. So obviously he's not going to have access to clean water. He's going to be a little bit dirty as well. So I'm just going to go in there with a little bit of matte eyeshadow just to get a little bit of dirt onto the skin. Just using quite a medium-sized brush to do this. Working over the soot. Checking from the front again. I want to get rid of this area here because I don't want anything mirrored. Finally, I'm just going to work in the little bit of black powder and just really work into some of the detail on the face just to build up the soot. I'm just using like a dappled effect with my brush, so just working into it quite sporadically, no real pattern. Let's just work into the eye a little bit as well, if you just look down. It's quite important to use your brush in quite a fluid manner. Got a few smudges. Don't forget the lips as well. Maybe a little bit of smudge just coming down the nose. If you put too much on, just remember to go use your round brush. Just clear it a little bit first and then go back into the design. Just put a few smudge lines on there with my fingers. can just twist off some of the design with the baby wipe just to create more of a dappled effect. I'm just going to smooth a little bit of the design as well with my fingers. So I'm quite happy with the design now. So what I'm going to do is just work into the hair a little bit, just the finish. And very lastly, it's very important to make sure you set your design, particularly if it's a little bit oily like this one is, with a white setting powder or with a setting powder, just to make sure, ensure that it lasts. And there you have it, a chimney sweep. So to achieve this look, I use the black stipple sponge. I use the Ben Nye Pressed Eyeshadow in dark brown. I use the Ben Nye Professional Clown Series Black. The Professional Paris Berlin Eyeliner. And the white setting powder, also by Ben Nye.